Hi everyone, Clanthony Downtano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of this new Amaarae album, Fountain Baby. Sophomore record here from Ghanaian-American pop singer and songwriter Amaarae. Honestly, went into this new record over here completely blind off of a random shade-filled comment or tweet I got somewhere on social media saying something like, so we're just like not gonna review the new Amaarae album. And I was like, oh, bitch, what is this energy? I'm gonna try this album out, and if it's mid, I'm gonna be so pissed. But no, it was actually fire. So Amaarae began to gain attention during the first year of the pandemic off a hot track that eventually gained so much traction, it eventually earned a remix featuring none other than Caliucci's, which makes total sense because I think Cali and Amaarae have a lot in common creatively. Maybe not in a super literal sense in that I think they sound exactly the same. I mean, there is certainly a common thread between them in that they both have respectively light, sweet, dreamy voices. But beyond that, I think a lot of their common ground is shared in the fact that they are super versatile pop artists that borrow from a wide variety of genres and care a lot about songcraft. And also take a pretty subtle approach. Now, making pop music that is super soft, super ethereal, it can be kind of a risk. Going too easy can often lead to things sounding maybe too forgettable or bland. And to be fair, there are a few moments on this record that do kind of meander, with Amaarae's vocals aimlessly exploring these very spacious beds of guitars and beats. But for the most part, these tracks actually have a high amount of impact, despite their also high level of elegance and chill, almost like that of an early FKA Twigs album. But way, 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 way warmer in terms of vibe, and I would say more danceable too. The versatility of this record is also apparent from the jump, with
Angels in Tibet,
which is like hot soup on a stovetop, with elements of African music, Asian music, and high art pop music all boiling together aggressively to the point where it's hard to tell what's what or if the song has any super defined origin to it. I would say that's also the case for the song Wasted Eyes. Also deeper into the record, we get tracks that fuse together elements of, again, pop, R&B, dancehall, Afrobeats, hip-hop, and electronic music too. The track Co-Star features all of these elegant harp arpeggios, set to bustling beats that are topped with a lot of funny and flirty lyrics about astrology and star signs. Instrumentally and vocally, the whole thing sounds like a silky sex dream. We have more themes of desire and temptation turning up on the track Princess Going Digital too, with some hot-ass grooves, drum fills, and call-and-response vocals. It's giving fantasy dance parts party in the city in the middle of the night. Meanwhile, with Big STEPPA, I don't typically like my dance hall this dreamy, but the touches of strings and background vocals and horns on this track are actually stellar. Multiple cuts above anything I've heard in the mainstream that has tried to take a lighter approach with this style of music. I could say much the same for the track Reckless and Sweet, which also puts a very pillowy veneer over a lot of West African music elements. Amaarae's vocals on this track also sound especially mesmerizing and intimate. Then, one of the most amazing, crazy, and surprising moments on the record comes in the form of Counterfeit. We have another bold banger on here with a lot of crazy cultural fusions that seem almost MIA-esque in how they just like kind of jam these various vibes and ideas together. But one of the most recognizable sounds on it is the steel drum lines from that Pharrell beat off the Clips album Hell Hath No Fury. For Wamp Wamp. As a huge Clips fan, it's kind of hard to not think of that track while listening to this, but still, Amaarae does make it her own. And I love on this record, she can drop a track that hot, that steamy, that in your face, but then also match it with the song Disguise, which is maybe the most whimsical and theatrical cut on the bunch, especially with the male-female vocal harmonies, the chilly atmosphere surrounding it all, and the refined touches of strings. The final leg of this record also keeps things pretty interesting with sex, violence, and suicide. The first portion of this track drags a little bit with Amaarae not really going anywhere fast vocally over some very spacey guitar arpeggios. It's kind of winding, it's a little repetitive, but eventually in the final leg of the song, it bursts out into this punk rock passage that honestly sounds more raw and interesting than many artists in the pop field, just quickly kind of going punk for a minute or two on a random song here and there. The guitar distortion combined with Amaarae's vocals being so high-pitched and shouty, it almost feels like Otoboke Beaver. Sociopathic Dance Queen is not just an excellent title for a song, but yet another dreamy pop banger. Aquamarine Loves Ecstasy, I think, could have used a bit more variation across its runtime, but still getting some big Sade vibes off of this track in the best way. Water from Wine, all I can really say about this one is it's pure ecstasy. And the closer, Come Home to God, is a big final moment on this record, and another surprising switch up too, because we get some rock drums and some shouty group refrains and some very eerie, breathy lead vocals on the verses too, which all make for an interesting contrast from these lyrics about kind of, you know, going crazy on the pole with over the top lyrics like when I'm in that pussy, I'm above the law. There's a heavy and sinister finish on the track as well, with like some distorted bass. And once again, really impressed with what Amaarae brought to the table on this album. The diversity, the texture, the tunes, the vocal performances, the details. This thing is creative, it's bold, it's sweet, it's enchanting. And honestly, I think she really knocked it out of the park on this thing. I'm feeling a strong 8 to a light 9 on this record. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head, it's another video you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Amaarae, forever.